Cheryl Cole nicknamed him her little brother, but Joe McElderry has certainly grown up since his days on X Factor. He'll be here to perform for us later on.
Now, it's a showbiz story we hear too often. An unknown singer becomes an overnight sensation after winning a talent show, only to disappear from the public eye just a couple of years later.
And when former X Factor winner Joe McElderry was dropped by Simon Cowell's label, that could have been his fate. But he went on instead to win a second talent show, pop star to opera star, and then notched up some more hit records.
And he's just released his fourth album. And for the first time, it features songs he wrote himself, including this one. Here's What I Believe.
I'm tired of hanging on to all the games you play. The lies you made, it won't work that way. You know I lead my cards right out for you to see. But you just steal what I wanna see.
Here he is.
Hello.
Very good morning. How are you?
I'm good, yeah, I'm very well.
Have you got some spikes on your shoulders?
I've got the spikes this morning.
Have you had the weight of the world on your shoulders? Yes, that's why you put the spikes on.
Keeps everybody who I don't want there off.
Well, to a certain extent, Joe, you have had the weight of the world on your shoulders. When you, as we mentioned earlier, you know, you have this sort of huge meteoric rise to fame on X Factor, and all's going well for a while, and then, boom, you're dropped.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I don't really look at it like that. I think it's viewed like that in the public, you know, because you read magazine articles and you see what happens. But to be honest, the period of actually being dropped from Psycho and going straight through into that show and then obviously signing the new deal was like a matter of 2 weeks. So to me, it was just like I had 2 weeks off. You know what I mean?
Yeah, so it was pop star to opera star, was that really helpful, the timing?
Oh, definitely. I mean, that was kind of... I was already ready to do that before I knew about the Psycho thing anyways. So it was kind of like, I was like, oh, well, I'm just doing this anyways, so I'm busy. So it kind of didn't really affect anything, you know, and then obviously I went on after that and...
Well, you did your classical album,
yes.
Didn't you?
Yeah.
Which was a huge success. Was there a point then when you thought, OK, is this my musical direction?
I kind of, you know, I did the classical album, I did the Christmas album, and then in January I kind of had a meeting with the label and I knew I wanted to kind of... explore my direction. You know, everything before that had been, obviously the classical was because of Pop Star Opera Star. Mm. The first album was because of X Factor. Mm. I thought, I want to go into the studio and not like go, right, this is what we're going to do straight away. I wanted to just go in and try things. So, you know, I spent the last 7 months, like, I've done a lot of writing, working with different people, trying different songs that I necessarily wouldn't sing. And kind of found a direction that I think suits us very well.
Because you wrote one song, I can't remember which one it was, and you played it to, what, friends and family, and they all said, oh, that's very nice, so that was a spark.
Yeah, I mean, it was actually my manager was like, please, please, please go in and try and write, and I didn't want to do it.
Didn't you want to do it? Why were you so reluctant?
I felt, I don't know, I'd always had songs written for us, or I'd done covers, and two, I kind of didn't feel I would be any good at it. So I thought, I don't want to kind of embarrass myself, you know. And I went in and I tried it with a friend of mine who's a really talented singer-songwriter. And
The really talented singer-songwriter being?
Jamie Squire is here. Yeah, he's going to play the piano today on the track. And we had a blast, you know, and I really enjoyed it. Mm. And played it at the label, played it at friends and family, and everybody started to like it. So I thought, OK, I'll try it a bit more. And then when obviously this got accepted as the first single, Here's What I Believe, I think I started to get the confidence and I've never stopped writing since.
Well, here's a secret for you. It's much better for you financially if you write your own songs.
Oh, well, I know that.
You get all the rights.
Yeah, never mind the confidence. I mean, surely that would have helped you get over it as well.
Yeah, I mean, I just think it's like, you obviously have to be a lot more personal when you're doing songwriting. And I think it's a lot more personal if somebody doesn't like the song or if somebody wants to change something about it, you know, and you have to get past that and then work through it, I think.
You feel exposed.
Yeah, totally, you know, and it takes a bit of getting used to like hearing the song that you've just played and knowing that that's stuff that I've written to what somebody else would have written. It's quite strange.
I always wonder how people write songs in what they do physically, where they go. You know, he's having a cup of coffee, writing on the back of the envelope. What do you do? Standing by the piano?
Well, here's what I believe was written with Marcella Detroit from Shakespeare Sister.
Who was also in Popstar, not my year, the year before.
Right. But we had a bit of a connection, but I'd never met her before. Went into the session and they were kind of like, so how are you feeling today, Joe? Like, what do you want to write about?
So you went into a set, you go into a studio,
yeah.
And she's there, and there's a piano and instruments.
She's got a guitar.
You say, okay, let's just start writing.
Yeah, and she was like, how are you feeling? And I was like, I don't know, Dan. And we're actually just flicking through something, and a conversation came up, and I said something like, why can't people just lay the cards out for everybody to see? And that's actually one of the lines in the song. We just started taking things from our conversation and writing it together. But then when you work with different people, you know, you can go in, somebody's playing a melody that you might like, and then you just fit lyrics. It totally depends who you're working with.
So it's about being honest and open.
Totally.
Well, that's a hard thing for anybody who is in the pop world to be, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, you know, it is. But I think it's also, it makes people relate to your music a lot more, which I've found, you know, and I can put a lot more emotion into stuff that's
honest.
Yeah,
because if you're going to write a song, a lot of people write songs. I mean, some write about experiences, but most people are writing about what they truly feel and what they're like inside out, so to speak.
Yeah, and you know, things that have happened and things that you've seen friends go through and family. You draw on all those experiences. So it's been a really interesting couple of months. You know, it's been. I felt like I hadn't recorded an album before because it was such a different process to the past three.
So you've done X Factor and you've done Popstar to Opera Star. Are there any other reality shows you'd like to do?
Everybody always asks this. Not at the minute.
Have you been asked to do any?
Yes, I have.
Which ones?
I'm not going to say.
Have you been asked to go into the jungle?
Not yet.
Would you?
I'm a bit scared of rats and all them kind of things. I could do the camping, love camping and things like
bugs?
That. But it would be the rats.
Big reality TV thing coming up for you this weekend. You're doing the Great North Run.
Yes.
Can you look after Sue? She's doing it as well.
Are you doing it as well?
And she's lost a toenail the other day.
Running.
Yes.
Yeah, so...
It's not nice.
Have you done it before?
I did it 20 years ago.
It's good fun. It is good fun, isn't it? It's a great atmosphere. I'm actually looking forward to it. It's for charity.
Have you been training a lot?
Yeah.
Have you?
I've been getting up extra early while I've been out promoting the album to make sure that I was running, because last year I did it and I made the mistake of thinking, I'm busy with work, I'll be fine.
That's my excuse. It was the biggest mistake ever.
The finish is great.
But don't worry, you'll be fine.
Because Mo Farah said he's not doing it because of the training, because he hasn't put the right training in. He's going to do a 2-miler instead. He's made the wise decision, hasn't he?
It's all for charity.
By the seaside, you'll love it.
It'll be great.
All right. Good to see you. And you're going to sing for us later, but you're not going to sing the single.
I'm going to sing a track off the album, which is out now, called When I Need You.
All right, lovely.
Is it the When I Need You we know?
Yes, it's the one you know.
Now to play us out, Joe McKelvey is back performing a cover of Leo Sayer's When I Need You. Have a great day.
Bye-bye.
When I need you, I just close my eyes and I'm with you. And all that I so want to give you, it's only a heartbeat away. When I need love, I hold out my hands and I touch love. I never knew there was so much love keeping me warm night and day. Miles and miles of empty space in between us. The telephone can take the place of your smile, but you know I won't be traveled in. It's cold out, but hold out and do like I do. When I need love, I hold out my hands and I touch love. I never knew there was so much love keeping me warm night and day. When